Hello everybody and welcome to this new video. And today we are going to talk about my, well, second favorite kind of modulation pedals, and is this one. It is a phaser pedal. I own a Block Script Phase 90, so one of the more modern versions, but I think, well, with a phaser, it is hard to go wrong. And why is it my second favorite? Well, I think my favorite kind of modulation is just a tremolo, because it's just so subtle. And as you might know, I am somebody who plays a lot of rhythm guitar. And well, I like to surf the song. And I think a lot of the effects pedals, they are too present in a song and too much, in the front and changing sound. Coarse pedals, I think they make your guitar sound too metallic, and I like the more, well, warmth and smoothness that a phaser pedal can give you. And why do you want to make this video? Well, last night the new Rolling Stones album came out, and I believe it was the third song, and they brought back the old phaser pedal. I was like, let's make a video about how, well, a phaser pedal can serve a lot of songs and ways of playing. So I got out my Tele again, plugged in straight to my Fender Blues Lux over here, and all the sounds are just my amp with the Sennheiser E906 straight into my Sony camera with no additional effects on it. Although maybe some, a little bit of reverb of the amp and drive, but that's it. Let's start with some sounds. Let's first put it on a really low setting. Clean channel. And this is clean, and can hear when you're playing rhythm, it's just like, it's there, but it isn't overwhelming. It just gives some nice spatial movement in your sound, and I really like that. Now let's put on the drive and go to the bridge and to a little bit the same part, like, and now it is really a biting tone, but it isn't too overwhelming, but it can really cut you through the mix. And now let's roll down the tone a little bit of the guitar. I think now it sounds even better. The first one is a little bit too bitey. Yes, it's a Telecaster. I know it's bitey, but this way I like it a little bit more. Now let's turn off the drive again. And now let's put a little bit faster. I put it on like, well, let's do 10 o'clock. And if I play a chord now, we start to get a little bit into, yeah, the, little bit more of like, yeah, the Pink Floyd-ish, David Gilmour-esque clean reed. I just love this sound. It's so nice and open, and even when you play like a little bit of country, I believe it was Carl Perkins, I believe, or Jennings. I don't know by sure. If you know it by correctly, put it down below. It was the guy who played with Johnny Cash a lot, but just like, you can even use it for country music, as you might can hear. So, and now let's turn on the drive, and what shall we do? Also a really nice tone. But now let's turn up a little bit far, so now it's in the 12 o'clock position. And now you're almost getting in like the Leslie-esque, Leslie speaker sound, like, let's do something like Badge. Little bit faster. And you can almost play like, don't know if you know the song, but... Okay, I'm gonna ask, too long ago since I played that song, I can't play it anymore, but I think you can get the... I think you can understand a little bit more Hendrix-y vibe, and now I got it on like the 1 o'clock position. It's a really nice sound. And now let's go to full speed. And for solos, well... I don't think it adds that much anymore to... But still, for like rhythm guitar playing and just adding some nice flavor to your chord playing. It gets this nice growly moving part to your sound, and I think, yeah, if you are a rhythm guitar player, you should have a phaser pedal, because just, yes, like I already said, this really nice and colorful tone to your playing, because if I turn it off and I'll play it. still a great sound, but... If you're playing like a pop rock band or anything, it just adds that little bit of edge which make you stick out if you play simple pop. And maybe it's because I'm a 90s kid and it's on a lot of the records I was listening to when I was like 12 to 16 or 18. And I hope now you can understand why I love this pedal so much, or this flavor of sound, because I don't care which phaser pedal you will be using. And maybe it's because I'm a 90s kid. Well, I'm born in the mid 80s, but when I started to get my musical taste and flavor, it was the end of the 90s, early 2000, and then there were a lot of the rock bands and stuff using these kinds of sounds. But as I showed you in this video, also earlier in like the country stuff and the psychedelic stuff, people were already using phaser pedals, and I think they are, as a rhythm guitar playing and somebody who is working in favor of the song instead of being the main guy in the front of the band, this kind of pedals add so much nice smoothness and warmth and flavor to your tone without being too much in the front. I think every guitarist should have at least one phaser pedal. And if you don't have any pedals yet, click on the link down below. Then you also help me creating more of these videos, because I hope you like these videos. And if so, please give them a thumbs up below, because I really enjoy sharing my passion and love for guitar and really reinventing the guitar, because as you might can hear, for about 5 years or something I hardly played guitar, and now I'm relearning everything and working on it, and I want to share my experience with you, and because maybe you're also like me, played when you're young and now rediscovering the joy and fun of playing music. And that's what I want to show to you, what I want to bring to you on my channel: the joy of playing guitar and sharing this with others. Okay, for me now it's hard to play with bands and stuff, so for me this is my way of sharing my joy of playing music with you. And if you want to see more of my videos, click down below on subscribe, or click here or for here for videos that I've made in the past. And then I hope to see you soon in another video. Bye bye.